Hi everybody, good afternoon. Today's Facebook Live, I'm actually just going to show you a large amount of the cues that I've trained my own dog to do. We thought she might have had some brain damage when she arrived at our home, and she actually has learned almost 100 different cues or cues and behaviors. So I'm going to actually show you, I put together a list this morning. And I'm just going to scroll through it really fast so you can see it, and then we're going to play. So let me flip the camera really quick. And ta-da! So yeah, I had to make a spreadsheet. And then I'm just going to scroll down really fast through. Whoa, look at all those cues! So all of these behaviors that she's learned, they include behaviors that I've taught by luring, by doing shaping or capturing, and some of them are actually behaviors that she has, it's been a combination of desensitization and counter conditioning, and a couple of behaviors are actually teaching her how to make a request for a specific thing, or tell me that she's ready to begin a husbandry activity. So nail clipping her, ear washing her, picking out the dirt from her eyes. Okay, so I'm going to have my assistant actually take the camera so I can handle the dog. So I'm going to flip this. And you all may see me go back to the computer to look at what other cues I'm missing. And the other thing you should know is my dog has a combination of luxating patellas and some hip dysplasia. So she actually is on some pain meds for management, and there are some things that she's going to do a lot slower than the average dog. So like getting into a sit or a down or changing positions, she does a little bit slower. And, you know, we do a lot to manage her pain, but it's not because she doesn't want to do the cue. Okay, so she's in a down stay right now in her crate, and I'm going to get her out of the crate, and then we'll get going. Okay, so Snorkel, coming out. Touch. Good job. Very good. That's one for you. Okay, next thing we're going to do is I'm going to show you how to get your stuff on. Woo! All right. So she knows how to dress herself. Stand. Get dressed. Good. Except for the clasp. Apparently her collar is lost. So we don't use this actually very much, but she knows how to put it on if she needs to. Snorkel. Get dressed.
What are you putting on her now?
This is a head halter, and I don't actually necessarily recommend that for every dog. I only recommend using that for dogs where you've done proper counter conditioning to get them to actually ignore this piece of equipment on their face, because it's actually very hard for them to enjoy a walk if they're annoyed by having something stuck to their face. All right. So that was one thing. Sit. Stand.
That way. Yes. Very good. Oh, is that stuck? Down. Loaf. Circle. Flop.
Okay, what about the other?
Wait. This is actually a really good behavior for husbandry. So if you need to get your dog in this position, it's nice to actually let them get into the position themselves. And that way you can, you know, examine their underside and see their feet without handling their feet if they don't like foot handling. Yes! Good job. Okay, let me see what we missed so far. Starboard. So that's just to get her onto the other side. What else do we not know how to do? Oh, good job. Let's just move into Peelu. And this kid, she's working for kibble. This is just her regular food in the house, because we don't need to use anything else in here. We can use toys, food, praise, whatever. Okay. Next, we're going to... We did that. You. Sorry, it's taking me a minute to look through the list. Ah, okay. Stay. Cold. Die. So that's a new one. She's learning how to hold an object until I tell her to release it. And you're also going to do, let's do this one. Gentle. Hold. A little bit more. Try again. Yes. So this is my wallet, which I'm going to trust her with. Okay, bring it. Yes.
Good job.
Very good. Take it. So I want to give her a really good reward because she did that. She tried really hard. Get it. Go get it. Okay. Very good. you want to just have that? Okay, all yours. Oh, you want to play more? Okay. Drop. Good job. Snuggle. Recliner. Good girl. Wait. That just means that she was supposed to go to her mat. That we taught all through shaping. Oh, let's do these. Excuse me. Good. We also taught this through shaping. Off. Out. Becky, keep going. There you go. Yes. Good job. Okay. Yes. Good girl. Okay. I feel like we're doing like a weird Laurel and Hardy show.
Who's Laurel and Hardy?
I don't know. All right. Next one. So this is a chin target? Yes! Good girl. Which is another really useful husbandry tool. You don't have to use a leopard skin, whatever this is. I just found something comfortable that looked unique for her to use for this. So when this thing goes down, her chin goes on it, wherever it happens to be, which is a really great thing to do when she goes to the vet. If we need to do an exam and she needs to stay still, it's perfect because you can take a look at her eyes and everything like that. Okay, snorkel. Stand. Yes. And this is, yes, it's a horse feed container, but what we use it for is wash your toes. Yes. I use that so that when we come into the door and her feet are muddy, I just put a wet towel in here and I have her do a couple of spins inside the bucket so she wipes her own feet off, and then I have her walk on a towel. We can also wipe her feet with little baby wipes, but this way she does the work for me. It's great. Circle. Sit. Yes, Good job. She also did not know how to catch before. She's pretty good at it now. Maybe I'll look at it. Catch. Can you do it from there? I don't think you can do it from there.
Face.
Okay, catch. Good. Very good. And what else can we do? We did that. Oh. Hey, circle. Stand. Spin.
Good job.
Twirl.
Yes.
Good. So right now she knows how to do a clockwise spin, and that's the S-P-I-N cue. She knows how to do a counterclockwise spin with a hand signal, but not with the verbal. So we're teaching her the verbal. What about? No. She also knows, we're just starting to, so I told you that she's learned several things by luring and several things by shaping or capturing. We're just kind of touching on the beginning of how to teach by mimicry. So one of the things that she does know how to do is circle.
Copy me.
Very good.
Okay. Ready? Copy me.
Yes. Good.
Copy me.
Yes. And we can talk more about learning through imitation later. There's actually a very specific kind of procedure to do it besides just showing your dog to do something. But it's actually really useful if you have a dog that you need to teach service tasks. So pulling things for you, picking things up for you. It's a much faster way for some dogs to learn different cues because you don't have to go through all the steps of teaching them how to do it. You just show them once, they copy you, and it's kind of done. And you can finesse it through shaping so that you can get more specific kind of topography, as they call it, to the cue. But I think it's fun. Okay, and I think, is there anything else that we want to show you? No, I think the only other thing I want to show you is two husbandry things that I'm going to go into further at another time. But for right now, snorkel. Sit. Wait. So this is something that I've taught her so that she can tell me when she's ready to do toothbrushing. And the way I do it is I offer her this toy. And if she takes it, that means she's ready to do the toothbrushing. And I also have her hold the toy so that it actually opens her mouth and I can see everything that I need to see.
Good job.
And she can have toothpaste as her treat.
Great.
And the last thing I'm going to show you. Something stuck in your mouth? I think something's stuck in your mouth. I'm going to take this off. There you go. Okay, can you see everything? Wait. Free. Touch. Down. So she already just kind of likes to do this, just kind of lie in your lap in this sandwich. And this is kind of a relaxed position that she already uses. And what we did was when she's ready to do nail trims or working with the Dremel, she has her face on that side of my lap. And we've done a lot of work with this. If I take her paw, is that too much? And she keeps her face there, then we can actually go ahead and do the work. If she brings her face up, the work stops. Good job. And if her face isn't there, she'll also, hey, snorkel. She could signal to me a second way, which is if she's ready and her face is in here, she can give her paw to me. And that actually is a signal that she's ready to start the husbandry, or ready to start the nail trimming or the nail dribbling. Good job. Oh, good girl. So I'm just going to do, I want to do a fake one because I'm not going to actually do her nails right now. Good job. All right. So that was everything. I don't know if I am able to see comments. Have there been any comments? Okay. Well, that's everything for today. I hope you enjoyed that. It was just basically the My Dog Show on a day which is moving kind of slow. So have fun with your dogs. Send comments, send questions, and we'll try to answer all your questions. Okay, bye, everybody. Enjoy your weekend.